Mrs. Gajra Kothari is an author and award-winning scriptwriter. She has published two short story collections titled Fragile Victories and The Last Laugh, and two novels, Broken Melodies in 2011 and Once Upon a Star in 2015, to critical acclaim. In 2013, she co-authored a Hindi novel called Kora Kagaz. She has written the story screenplay for several iconic television shows, including Astitva, Ek Prem Kahani, Jyoti, Veera, and Buddha, and has been doing story development for the show Balika Vadhu since its inception. The show has crossed the 1,833 episode mark on the 3rd of March 2015 to now hold a record for being the longest running Hindi fiction soap in India.
I developed a story for this show called Balika Vadhu, which we've just created history as of breaking a record yesterday. We are the longest running Hindi fiction show in India. But it's not just the numbers. I would like to believe this is a pioneering show which is known for having woven the social messaging along with a very entertaining style of storytelling. And it all begins with the story, good or bad. It's not that we have only got bouquets for what we have done. I've got plenty of brickbats also. But coming back to the point of ultimately connecting with the audience, because it's the emotion and the drama that you trigger off, which is entertaining for the audience to view. And it is that which is a tool in our hand to be able to give the message which the experts would like us to have delivered, not in a very talking down manner, but in a manner which connects with the audience, which is always a challenge, because the audience in India is not a uniform, one class, one thinking, one educational level audience. There are many Indias, there's a Bharat, there is an India, and there are lots and lots of people to connect with who have varying mindsets. In the course of developing the story of Balika Vadhu, which is about a child bride, one of the first things that we all assumed, all of us, my senior colleague Purnendu Shekhar, who is the person from whom the concept has come, he has seen it very closely because he comes from a region where child marriage is very intensely in practice. And all of us down the line who were researching the issue of child marriage, we all felt, okay, child marriage is something illegal, it's not supposed to happen. And therefore, when we came to a certain point in the story, we felt that we got into the mind of one of the characters there who said, fine, I've been married as a child, I don't agree with what happened to me, so I'm going to go ahead and marry as an adult, and that marriage is going to be the valid and the correct one. And this is what we as makers believed too, until we met an expert. We met an expert who actually layer by layer peeled for us what the law really said, and that changed our course of storytelling for the next couple of months. The law actually said that even when two children are married against their will, after they turn 18, if within 3 years they do not complain that they were married forcibly, and they have managed to, as adults, approve of each other, then their marriage is as solid and as legal as any other marriage. It's not an illegal marriage. So we were faced with a situation in our storytelling where a legal opinion completely altered our course of storytelling when we had reached this point maybe around 2 years ago. So that's the importance of law, and that we felt as a team so wonderful that we ourselves were educated and we were able to impart this to our viewers who might have been under the same misapprehensions as we had been until some time ago. So I can't underestimate the power of getting the expert opinion from lawyers, from medical experts, and from social activists, which is the very concept that we are here to discuss. So I think it's just wonderful. It's so important for all of us to interact on this.
I have a question. Actually, it's not really a question, it's a comment. on the need and the role for specialists and people who might be technically not qualified but knowledgeable about a subject that is being represented. I think what we tend to ignore is the transformation of society itself. I happen to be a social expert. And just to talk about a story, I'm not talking about fiction here, but I'm talking about what might be documentary realism. And one book that comes to mind is Madhur Jaffrey's memoir, Under a Mango Tree. Now, in that book, she describes, I would say, the transformation of Delhi after 1947. It is quite wonderful to read about how India was gripped by what was a huge humanitarian crisis, where hundreds and thousands of new immigrants, in fact, many millions of immigrants, spilled over across the border into a city like Delhi. We are not talking about village communities or lives as they existed during colonialism. We have an urban society today, largely urbanizing at a rate which is exponential. We have nuclear structure of family. So within that context, talking about reclaiming what is community, what is family, I think it is extremely contentious. So my question to the panel is that should we keep revisiting how wonderful life might have been where the whole family could be available to children?
I think for creators like us who are putting forth content which people are observing and analyzing all the time, it's not enough to be nostalgic about an era gone past or certain value systems which were in existence earlier, but which cannot be implemented or stay functional in the present context. So it's a tightrope walk for writers to keep the nostalgia bit where it is making sense and also to be able to move on. I can give you the example of our show wherein our oldest character and perhaps in many ways our most popular character, Dadisa, who was very different when we started the journey. She was an autocrat. She was the one who made things move. But over the course of several months, several years, she has become sensitized, a person of that generation. So I think if one chooses to tell a story like that, a story of even an older generation person who continues to retain what is so important for our children to retain also, and yet she has changed herself. So the idea is that there is a journey involved for everyone. There's evolution involved for everyone through the characters that we speak about in our story. So the media has a very big role to play, as in create a specific and a journey which is something that people feel elevated about when they watch, cutting across rural, urban, young, old, all the barriers, and tell an elevating story. So I think that's where the media can get in. And of course, along with the elevated storytelling, what we also need is accuracy, which sometimes, as creators, we face this battle all the time, because something which is fact is sometimes boring, it is documentary, it is not enough, it's not interesting enough. But how we weave that, how we stay true to our facts and not mislead the audiences for whom we are writing and projecting our content, and at the same time give a message which is progressive. I think that's the challenge all of us face, and that's something we are all helped when we discuss at a forum like this.